Ladies and gentlemen, the Kevin Owens Show is back on Monday Night Raw. I know you missed me, but before I tell you all where I've been, let me bring out my guest. Please welcome Riddle.
You know, I didn't necessarily miss the KO show, but I do appreciate his guest, the original bro Riddle. Not a bad choice at all.
I hate to break it to you, but even Riddle thinks you suck.
That's unconfirmed.
No, it's confirmed. I confirmed it with him at the bar the other day.
Riddle always entertaining. Missing his boy Randy, but fighting with so much heart on behalf of RK-Bro.
Yeah, we've seen another level of passion, another level of intensity week after week for Riddle.
Oh, the flops are flying, and so are the giraffes on the KO show.
Figure out how he does that.
Oh, this is where he's going to need his intensity for 1 week from Saturday, because Riddle's going to be taking on Seth freaking Rollins, and the lead-up to this match has been absolutely vicious.
Yeah, two men who clearly have a large degree of disdain for each other. That is going to be an absolute battle at SummerSlam.
Bro, I just wanted to say thanks for having me on the show, but you know why I'm here. You promised me a Mountain Dew Baja Blast, bro, so where is it?
I have no idea what you're talking about, but that's okay. I'll explain. What do we do with this? Do you just toss it? There we go.
Sometimes they get it.
That's all good. Let's have a seat, right? Riddle, first of all, thank you for being out here. Now, I don't know anything about Mountain Dew, but here's why you're out here, okay? See, the last few weeks, I haven't been around. I'm sure you've noticed. Maybe you didn't notice. I don't really. You're in your own little world all the time. But see, the last few weeks, I had to step away because the last few months, I was obsessed. Nearly drove myself crazy trying to prove that Ezekiel and Elias were the same person, right? And a few weeks ago, I came so close to absolutely losing my mind, I realized I had to take a step back, and that's what I did. I went on a nice little nature retreat, trying to find my inner peace, you know? And while I was away, I would watch Raw every week, and I realized there's something about you that I admire. See, you come out here, and you're constantly cool and calm and collected, and I look, I don't know if you have any kind of assistance in being that way, but I thought, I need to be more like that. So that's what I did, right? I centered myself and I realized I don't care about Ezekiel or Elias or Elrod. I don't care, okay? I don't care about any of them. In fact, I wish them the best. Actually, you know what? That's not true. I hope they fail miserably, but that's besides the point. I don't care. They can do whatever they want. The reason I called you out here is because of your match at SummerSlam. And that match is against Seth Rollins. And see, Seth Rollins is somebody else who caused me great anguish in the last few months. You know why? Because Seth used to be my best friend. At least he pretended to be my best friend. You remember? Right? And then he betrayed me. He betrayed me. He humiliated me. He insulted me when I was fighting my heart out for him. I lost my best friend that night. Just like you lost your best friend, Randy Orton. I'm just saying the truth. But it's okay, you see, because look, everybody needs some backup, especially here in WWE. And I realize the answer is right in front of me. Riddle, look man, RK-Bro was good. But Bro KO could be great.
Bro KO. I love it.
Yeah.
I love the sound of it. I love the potential. And Tampa, Florida loves it too.
Whoa. Let's not get ahead of ourselves. Now, Kev, if I'm being honest, bro, and I'm honest, you're like the biggest liar I know, dude.
Facts.
Come on.
Look, I understand why you'd say that, given my past. However, let me tell you, you can trust me when I say I've turned over a new leaf. I'm not that way anymore. I will never, nobody will ever be able to call me a liar again, okay? If you give me time, I'll prove that to you. Besides, you trusted Randy Orton, okay? The biggest snake in the history of WWE. Nobody has ever been less trustworthy than Randy Orton, okay?
You know what, Kevin? I don't like it when you talk about my best friend Randy like that. And if I would have known you would take me out here and talk to me like this, I would have came out here at all. And now I'm done talking, bro.
Uh-oh. Oh. You made a mistake now, KO. Uh-oh.
I have nothing to do with that. No, I have nothing to do with that. I have nothing. Dude, no.
And he has the face of Riddle hearing voices in his head.
Well, it's really my... Oh! There he is. There's Seth Rollins
with a stomp on Riddle. Set up.
A nodding smile on the face of the visionary.
Wasn't a setup. It was simply Rollins outsmarting the original bro again.
Always willing to do a little bit more before and after a match.
Well, he's clearing the way.
Oh no,
the Riddles are Riddles in
all sorts of jeopardy right now.
Out again.
Oh, another stomp.
You know what this is. This is a clear message from Seth Rollins to Riddle.
It is. It's a brilliant message from Seth freaking Rollins, just stomping all the malted hops and bong resin out of Riddle's skull
and absolutely reveling it.
Is this the scene we will witness
at SummerSlam?
Yep.
When Seth Rollins takes on Riddle.
Clearly, Seth Rollins wants to make this a preview of what's going to happen a week from Saturday. Well, someone else has had to deal with a lot of vicious attacks have been Rey Mysterio and his son Dominic, but they have been at the hands of the Judgment Day.